today's workout. So kit-wise, what we are going to need today is, if you've got something to do pull-ups on, the hardest movement of today is going to be chest to bar pull-ups, and that is kipping or butterfly. If we don't have a pull-up bar, we're going to do either rows on a towel or rows on TRX or rings. If you haven't got that, then you're going to do renegade rows, which is a plank, and you're going to be pulling dumbbell up towards armpit, sort of chest area, in that plank position. Okay, so that's the sort of kit that we need for the start bit. Overhead squat. So hardest movement is overhead squat with a barbell. If we don't have that, you're going to go heavy with a backpack, okay, if you can. And that's going to be one arm straight overhead, going down into that squat, back up. If you don't have the backpack, then we can go kettlebell, dumbbell. All right, something that's achievable to keep the straight arm locked out overhead as we're going into that squat. So that's going to be the first section of sort of gymnastic pulling strength. Then we have got a 12-minute, which is 12 air squats, 6. It's meant to be bar facing burpees, but we'll do the object facing burpees. Okay, so if you've got an object, you're going to face that object, do your burpee, and then you're going to jump over the top of it to the other side. Okay. It is meant to be 3 power cleans with a barbell, okay, you can check the weight of that. So if we've got dumbbell, kettlebell or odd object, we're going to do squat cleans. Okay, so we're focusing on using the hips and dropping under that weight. So if we were doing squat cleans with the dumbbell, we focus on from here, up, drop and stand. Okay. So 3 rows in the workout. So that's the kit that we need for the second and third bit. For our warm up, we're just gonna start getting a wee heart raiser, and then we're gonna do our Y arm raising on the box. Okay, so we're raising one arm for 3 seconds, and then the other arm. We'll do that after we get our heart raiser on the go. So we're gonna start with 1 minute of high knees. Okay, and then 1 minute of heel kicks, and then we're going to do 1 minute of one burpee every 5 seconds. Okay, so starting with our high knees, 10 seconds. Let's do this. 3, 2, 1, off we go, high knees. Keep them nice and high, guys, higher than the hip. Okay, up, up, up. Good. Okay, we're gonna go the full minute. Then we'll change on to our heel kicks. Good guys, 20 seconds, keep it going. Knees nice and high. Ten. Two, one, change on to heel kicks. So heel up towards the bum. Okay, try and kick the bum with the heel. Guys, keep going. Heels nice and high. Twenty seconds to go. Three, two, one. Down for burpee. Okay, let's go. Down we go. Okay, pause, pause. Burpee. And down. And burpee. Down. Down. And down. 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 Down we go. And again. And again. And one last one. Awesome, good. Okay, so we need a box and we need a mat. Mat just for the knees. Okay, down into knees on the floor, head and chest towards the floor. And you're just gonna raise one arm, hold for one, two, three, and then the other arm. One, two, three. Try to keep the head and the chest towards the floor. You're gonna do 20 in total. Okay, 10 side. Yeah, off we go, guys. I said, Jackie, head and chest towards the floor. Good. Try and raise that arm up.
Oh my God. Emma, what do you do? What do you do when it's not like, when it throws you out? Somebody's logged, it said someone's logged in another device. Oh, is it still on?
It's still on.
Okay. Two seconds.
Go into, click on this. And then go.
Right, keep going, guys.
Hold on, see if there's the icon at the side here. Usually just click on that and it
goes. You can still hear me. Right. Okay.
On you go, guys.
Okay.
I don't know what happened.
Oh, there's the icon.
Awesome. Try and keep that chest towards the floor. So you're focusing on using your upper back. That's it. Helena, if you go back a bit and create a neutral spine. Yeah, so knees back a bit. Yeah, creating neutral spine and then raise an arm. Good. Better. Awesome, good. Okay, so we're gonna do prep for our workout. We're gonna start with 8 alternating bird dogs. So on the knee and hands. From here, you're gonna keep nice and central and not swing from side to side. And focus on pressing out knee and hand and really stretching. Foot and hand one way, and then the other side. Okay, so that's going to be 8 in total, so 4 a side. Then we're going to do renegade rows or pause body rows. So if you've got rings or TRX, then you can pause at the top. If not, then we're going to do our renegade rows and pause at the top. So. Pause for 2, back down. Okay. Try not to have too much of a heavy weight for the pauses.
So four aside on that. Eight hollow rocks. So our hollow rocks, pointing the toes, keeping everything nice and tight. And then from here we're gonna go down and we go from W to Y. W to Y. And eight of them. So eight of each exercise, and it's a 3 minute rolling clock.
Okay.
So starting with our bird dogs. Nice flat back, and then stretch the arm and foot out. Okay. Take your time, make sure you're keeping everything nice and active. Keep your head down, neutral spine. You can try and stretch that arm so it comes up the same height as the head. Stretch your heel towards the back of the room. Then it's renegade rows or body rows. So four aside or eight in total. And so you go for plank position. Yeah. Up. One, two, back down. Okay. Guys. We've got eight whole rocks. So yeah. Nice tight core. Not move at the hip at all, point the toes. Good. And then W to Y in the front position. Keep the head down, don't strain the neck as you're doing your WYs. You guys, two, one. Awesome. Rest there. Nice. So, as I said before, chest to bar, body rows, or renegade rows. Okay. I want you to try and use the heaviest weight you can for your renegade rows. It's going to be five aside. No pause like we were doing. It's just up and down. Okay. So five aside. So 10 in total chest to bar, 10 in total body rows, or 10 in total renegade rows. Then 10 overhead squats, either with a barbell, or if we don't have a barbell, we're going one arm, backpack, kettlebell, or dumbbell. Now, if we haven't done much of this, I want you to practice it, because keeping that arm locked out as you go into a squat is really difficult. If we can't manage to keep that arm locked out and we start bending the arm, then we're going to think of an alternative. Okay, there's no point in just doing movement for the sake of it if it isn't correct. So let's try overhead squats. Okay, what option are you going to use? Good, Scott. Maybe I've done Helena. Awesome, guys. What weight are you going at, Helen?
I was just going to ask you.
Okay, so let me get my phone 2 seconds. Helen, have you got your phone on you?
Yeah.
Can you just double check Wordify what it says? I think it's meant to be a 15k dumbbell, so if you go either the dumbbell or if you go 30k on the barbell.
Yeah, it says dumbbell. Well, just use a dumbbell.
Yeah, just go the one arm dumbbell. But Jackie, you can go practice your overhead squat with the barbell, yeah? Good. So left and right arm, you're quite confident, guys. Davey, you going wooden pole just to keep that good movement, yeah? Good. That's it, mate.
Is that five each arm with it when you're doing the overheads?
Five on
right, and then five.
So actually, what we'll do is we'll do 10 for one round.
Okay.
Now it's going to be 6 rounds, and you're going to have a minute's rest after the round. Okay. Helen, you're going to have 20 seconds rest. Okay. Have you got your own clock? You got your own sort of stopwatch? So you'll need your own sort of minute's rest after you do the 2 exercises. So your renegade rows, overhead squats. Helen, for the comp programming, it's 10 and then it's a 20 seconds rest, and then it's 10 and then it's a 20 seconds rest.
Okay. I'm going to try and do pull-ups on my
bar.
But I sort of...
Do unbroken chest bar, so go as many as you can.
I do chest bar on it because it's not that stable.
All right, okay. So go unbroken, what, strict pull-up?
Yeah, yeah. Try.
Awesome. Right, if we get ready, guys.
Sorry, Chris, how many is that each exercise, please?
10 of each. So you do your 10 renegade rows, 5 aside, and then you're going to do 10 overhead squats on your barbell or one arm, and then on the next set, you're going to do 10 on the other side.
Okay, thanks.
Right, guys. Let's get going all at the same time. So, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Awesome. So big lockout. So try and keep that arm locked out, Scott. That's it. Press up. Good, mate. Nice big deep breaths as you're going down. So your back's going to want to give up. Just try and lock out the arm, press up whilst you're under fatigue. Sit. Good, so back in after your minute. Nice. Good guys, keep that arm locked out. Nice, Davey. Try and bring the hands in just slightly for me. That's it, mate. Focus on punching up. Good, just so you're getting a stretch. Good, Jackie. Stay back on those heels, heels, heels. Davey, is that you doing some panel beating whilst you're on your rest? Good guys. Punching up. Keep that arm locked out. Good. Come on, guys. Staying weight on the heels. Sit. Bring that head forward, Jackie. Yeah. Thank you. Come on, David, try and keep those hips down. Use the arms, that's it. Awesome. So bringing those hands in a bit again, Davey. Yeah, bring them in. Good. On chop. So, Davey. What I want you to try and do is, because you've got the wooden pole, see it as a sort of stretch as well. So bring those hands in so that the bar's sitting at the waist if you've got it down here. And then really kind of lock it out there and take your time, drive up. Take your time down, drive up. Good, mate. So you're getting a stretch, that's it. Punch up, punch up. Awesome, man. That's looking so much better. Go on, guys. Keep those arms locked out and overhead squats. Jackie, set. Nice, Helena. Jealous of your mobility. Helen. Nice, Davey. Let's get a good stretch. Hold it back there. Take your time on the way down and then drive up. Good. Take your time. Drive up. Awesome. Six rounds go. So Helen, it's 50, I think. Good, Davey. Keep it back, keep it back. Nice. Okay, awesome guys. So next bit, we've got a 12 minute AMRAP. It's gonna be 12 air squats. So making sure we're getting full depth in those squats, driving out. And six bar facing burpees, or if we're using the dumbbell, we're gonna do dumbbell facing burpees and jump over the dumbbell to the other side. Okay, so six of those, and then three squat cleans if it's with the dumbbell. So focusing on getting tall and drop under, catch, drive it up. Okay, and you can change arm, three of those, and keep moving. Okay, so try keep moving all the way through the 12 minutes. That's it, Davey, elbow nice and high. So if you're using the kettlebell, you want to try and create a cradle and not allow your arm, see if you've got your arm away out here, how it would leave a massive gap. Okay, so pull the knuckles towards the chin if you're using the kettlebell. So use the hips, knuckles towards the chin. Knuckles towards the chin. Yeah. There you go, that was better. That was a better catch. Yeah. Okay, let's try some squat cleans if we're using the dumbbell. Better to have the dumbbell facing sort of away from you at this angle if it's in between the legs. So you can use your hip and drop immediately under it and get the elbow nice and high, receive on the shoulder. Okay. Good. So good. What I want you to get away from is using your arm first, so like turning it into a bicep curl, then dropping underneath. I want you to focus on keeping the arm nice and straight. Use the hips to make it weightless and drop underneath it. So instead of like this, I want you to go hips, drop, and catch. Better.
Chris, what's the move if you're using a barbell?
It's power cleans.
Power cleans, thank you. Is that from which just?
Three power cleans from the floor.
From the floor?
Yeah, it's meant to be 50, but just got a weight that's acceptable, Jackie.
60 on.
Yeah.
Okay.
50 is maybe achievable.
Yeah, in my dreams.
No. At all. Okay, good to go. Let's do this, team. Right, 10 seconds. Three, two, one, off we go. 12 air squats. Jumping over the object. Six burpees. Three cleans. Trying to drop into that squat catch. Good guys, so trying to keep this pace all the way through. Good, Jackie. Get those hips back in the receive. So hips back. Yeah. Good guys. So keep the pace up. Come on, let's try and keep moving. Good, keep that knuckle towards the chin, Davey. So up, up, up. Yes, good. That was better, mate. Go on, guys. Chest up in the squats. Go on, keep the pace up. Good guys, halfway. Let's keep it up, come on. Come, Davey. Nice, go on. Scott, if your hips annoying you, mate, turn it into dumbbell snatch if you can't do these, if those squat cleans are irritating your hip.
It's just squats in general.
Is it? Aye, so dumbbell snatch so that you're not having to squat down. And then you can try lunges instead of the squats.
Okay.
See if it makes a difference. Go on, guys, keep your head in it. Keep the pace going. Okay, I said, Davey, try and stay on the heels and the squats. Good. Doing well, guys. Go on. Go on, back in. Right, 2 minutes to go. Let's push this last bit. Go on, straight in.
That's it, let's go, let's go. Last minute, come on. Push, push, push. Try and get your round finished. Thirty seconds. Let's go, let's go. 20 to go. Come on, don't give up now. 10 seconds. Three, two, one, time. Boom. Well done, team. That was awesome. Good. Scott, will you manage to make a 12 o'clock stretch?
What was that? Sorry?
You managed to make the 12 o'clock stretch class, the mobility.
Yeah, I think so. I'm golfing it too, but yeah, so that should be fine.
Okay. Yeah, I would do that just to kind of release the hip and stuff. If it's
I've had problems with it for ages.
Oh, have you?
No matter how much I stretch it, it's the more I do core, the worse it gets.
I don't know. Maybe better see. Have you seen a physio?
Yes, I've been to people. Like, it's not the hip flexor. It's some muscle like ilianakis or something like that. It's like the tiniest little thing. So like, if I try and do like L sits or anything like that, it pinches.
Yeah. Do you use the ball? Do you use like?
Sometimes that just irritates it more though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's weird. My body's just weird.
That's annoying.
But, yeah, I know. So, yeah.
Well done, team. I look sweaty.
Very sweaty.
Muggy.
Roasting today as well.
Proper muggy, eh? Mm.
Oh, God.
What's up, be up to? Nice new plates, Helen.
Yeah, I had to get them for Harris because he's bench pressing so much now.
You didn't win them.
Well, he started off wanting to improve his chest, so.